So a very good morning to one and all. So last class we discussed, so what does mean by signal, definition of signal, and then types of signal. So signal in the sense it carries or convey the information from one place to another place. So it can be divided into one dimensional signal and multidimensional signal. And then the basic types of signal: continuous signal and discrete signal, periodic signal and aperiodic signal or non-periodic signal, energy and power signal, deterministic and non-deterministic signal, even and odd signal, and bounded and unbounded signal. So in that class we are going to discuss about basic elementary signal. So here we are having so many elementary signals called step function or called unit step signal, impulse function or called impulse signal, ramp function or called ramp signal. So these are the elementary signals in signals in system. So each signal has some condition and have some property. So it satisfy the condition means it called as step function, impulse function, ramp function. So this is nothing but elementary signal. So this is a condition for unit step function or unit signal. So in that elementary signal, both CT and DT is having the elementary signal. Both CT and DT is having the elementary signal. Okay, so CT can be represented by x of t and DT can be expressed as x of n. So last class I explained. So how to represent these CT signal means x of t. How to represent the DT signal means x of n. So in elementary signal also we are having both DT and CT signal. That is unit step for both CT and DT. Similarly, ramp function also both CT and DT, and parabolic function also both CT and DT. Exponential signal also both CT and DT. Okay, so in that slide shows the unit step function for both CT and DT. That is continuous time signal and discrete time signal. That is u of t which is equal to 1, where t greater than or equal to 0, which is equal to 0 for t less than 0. So this is a condition for unit step function or unit signal for continuous time signal. Whereas DT signal, u of n which is equal to 1, n greater than or equal to 0, which is equal to 0 for n less than 0. So this is a condition for unit step signal or unit step function for DT signal. So this slide shows the condition for unit impulse function. So this is also both CT and DT. So unit impulse function for both CT and DT. So here del of t which is equal to 0, t not equal to 0, which is equal to 1, t which is equal to 1. So it can be represented as minus infinity plus infinity del of t into dt which is equal to del of t into dt which is equal to 1. So in the case of dt, del of n which is equal to 1 for n which is equal to 0, which is equal to 0 for n not equal to 0. So this is a condition for unit impulse function for ct and dt. So unit impulse function can be represented by del of t in ct signal. Similarly, unit impulse signal can be represented by del of n in dt signal. The next is unit ramp signal or unit ramp function. It can be represented by r of t. So r of t, which is equal to t, where t greater than or equal to 0, which is equal to 0, t less than 0. So this is for ct. R of t, which is equal to t into u of t, that is t into unit step signal. You can multiply with unit step signal, we can get the ramp signal. So that is the condition. So u of t, which is equal to d by dt of r of t, which is equal to d by dt, which is equal to 1 for ct. For dt signal, r of n, which is equal to n for n greater than or equal to 0, which is equal to 0 for n less than 0. So this is a condition for unit ramp function.